Thanks for tuning in to 2K Sports for this NBA presentation. With Greg Anthony and Hall of Famer Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan. And we're pleased to have on the sidelines tonight, David Aldridge. DA, it's all yours.
Kevin, thanks. Last season, some people called on Joel Embiid to be more aggressive. The process accepted that with humility, saying, I want to be great, and it's only right for people to expect me to drop 35 a night. At the same time, he said, I'm not a selfish player. If the defense double teams me, it's about making the right play. Kevin?
David, he is showing that maturity. Thanks for that report. Already it's February. Let's see how the East is matching up. You take a look at the 76ers. They've been in peak form as we've watched them play some tremendous basketball with an eye toward the postseason. And, of course, there's Toronto, five games behind.
And for Philadelphia, they've come through for their fans this season. All the optimism surrounding them, all the high hopes, all proved to be legit.
Well, how about the momentum they have built to get off to this fantastic start? All positive vibes right now for this group.
Look at the 76ers starting group. Harris and Embiid hold down the post for him. Simmons is out there with Curry, and it's Green in at the small forward position. And for Toronto, Lowry and Van Vliet are the guard set. Anunoby out there with Pascal Siakam, and it's Powell in at the three spot. Greg, is a point guard, what is it you like to see from that position on the floor?
I think first and foremost, leadership. It's so valuable at that spot. And, you know, you always got to have your head high because your teammates are feeding off what you put forth in terms of your body language and enthusiasm. So, you know, the typical stuff about organizing the offense and setting the tone on the defensive end, that stuff's important as well. But so much of how you carry yourself out on the floor when you deal with adversity and you know that you're going to, it is really paramount.
Now here's Simmons following the miss by Fred Van Vliet, and the shot goes down.
And the man just brings his lunch pail and goes to work. What sets Embiid apart is he does it with such ease.
Here's Siakam, rejected by Harris, and they'll keep possession. Yep, that one goes in there. We're about 1 minute into the first. Simmons looking it over. The pass to Embiid. Over Siakam. It's rebounded by Anunoby.
You're not going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on that one.
Here's Powell, coming off a solid outing against Minnesota. Pass to Siakam. Back to Lowry. Clock is at three. Toronto needs to get off his shot. For three, Van Vliet. Whoops, there's the 24-second shot clock violation, so they'll turn it over. How about that strong defensive performance for this half's Mobile One block?
And early in the game, a defensive play like that goes a long way establishing the attitude you want.
For Philadelphia, they've gone 2-3 here to start out the game.
Hey, yo, front him.
Pass to Harris. Here's Embiid. Beyond the arc. Leaps for it. Harris, no good. Anunoby passes to Siakam. Drives to the hoop. Now on the scoring column with that bucket. 1-for-2 this game.
Well, Pascal Siakam's handle has gotten tighter, and that makes a dribble drive a problem for the defender.
Embiid against Siakam. Now here's Embiid. D right on him. He gets that one. Embiid's got 6 points. And it's Van Vliet with the ball for the Toronto Raptors. Trailing by two. They're coming off that win against Minnesota.
Yeah, they really snuffed that one out. Didn't execute all that well. Fortunate to walk away with the W.
Yeah, but as a team, you actually love a win like that. You're struggling from the field. You don't have your best stuff. Still, you find a way to gut out a win.
And with Kyle Lowry, the assist numbers don't jump off the page at you, but he has fantastic vision, and his decision-making is also elite.
Greg, for me, what stands out about Kyle Lowry is his willingness to adjust his game based on what his team needs. There's been times in his career where he's been a go-to scorer, and his three-point shooting can be infectious to his team. That toughness on the drive really strikes you. But there's also been times where he takes a back seat to scoring and says, all right, time to get my guys involved. He can do either.
Now here's Curry. 9 points last game. Here's Simmons. And he uses the glass on the layup.
And this is how Simmons puts up points. He challenges you close at the rim more often than not, having the physical advantage.
Lowry against Simmons. Out of bounds. Philadelphia takes possession.
And let's take a quick look at some stats for VanVleet. Just an incredible month of basketball. He's averaging 20 points, 6 assists, and just over 2 steals. And what is crazy is that these numbers might not even do his game justice. He's been phenomenal.
Feels like every night this guy does something that just blows your mind. So fun to watch. Someone the other players look up to.
Raptors trail by 4. Pass to Anunoby. Lowry deciding where to go with it here. And so it's Harris who will bring it up for the Philadelphia 76ers. Their last encounter was in Philadelphia.
And they got the better of this matchup last time with their defensive pressure and the ability to force turnovers.
Yeah, I thought the giveaways were a tremendous factor. They were taking some chances on D, jumping in the passing lanes, that sort of thing. And it really paid off for them. Well, the advantage they have right now is largely based on his play. What an outstanding night.
A new group in now for the Raptors. Aaron Baines, he's checked in for Siakam. Stanley Johnson comes in for OG Anunoby. Andre Bembry's checked in for Norman Powell. And it's Terrence Davis in for Fred VanVleet. And the 76ers will go for a different look here. Howard's checked in for Tobias Harris. Korkmaz comes in for Green. Shake Milton, he's checked in for Curry. And Maxey's subbed in for Ben Simmons. Johnson for 3, and he's good on the 3-ball.
We call that floor vision, gentlemen. Kyle Lowry with the pretty pass.
Now, here's Maxey. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Aaron Baines. That's his first foul. Matt Thomas, he's checked in for Kyle Lowry. And Philadelphia also making a switch. Feibel's checked in. Howard kicks to Thibault.
Well, they are daring him to miss, and he obliges.
Raptors trail by 3. Down low, here's Thomas. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws. Emphasizing the importance of a deep bench, a few teams, Doris, across the league are riddled with injuries right now.
And this is where your front office has to find a way to be successful year after year. Players over the course of a season maybe won't play for 5, 6, 7, 8 games, and then an injury opens an opportunity, and you have to have a high level of professionalism at the end of the bench to endure these moments.
Free throw good, Thomas. He's off on the second. Philadelphia's gone 0-3 from three-point land. Nothing yet going outside. And the pass to Howard. And here's Maxey into the lane. Count it. Good.
Yeah, still commanding a lot of defensive attention. Howard just keeps his head up and finds the open man.
1:21 left to play here in the first. Bembry the pass to Thomas. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. That's on Dwight Howard.
And really the defense fouling there to prevent the layup, but that's exactly what you need to do.
And guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown for Philadelphia.
And so far, these guys have done a fantastic job finding the open man and getting some easy baskets.
They've also made their mark in the paint. A lot of their scoring coming down low so far.
That's good from Thomas. And both free throws good for Thomas. The 76ers leading. 103 left here in the first quarter. And the call will be made against Matt Thomas. That is his first foul of the game. There's 57 seconds left in the first. Pass to Korkmaz. Back to Thibault. Five on the clock. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. First trip to the free throw line for him in this one.
Not the best statistic for him in terms of his performance at the line. Very low numbers.
And the first one drops. Chris Boucher's checked in for the Raptors. He makes one of two that time. And so it's Johnson who brings the ball up for the Toronto Raptors. It's a three-point game. Here's Davis out to the right wing. And again, Toronto no luck. The 76ers have gotten 6 of 11 shots to go down so far. Pretty nice shooting. We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Maxi, no good. Toronto's gone a meager 1-6 from three-point land since we got started tonight. Pass to Boucher. Dishes it to Davis. From deep three-point range, and that shot was up in time, but doesn't go in. A big-time effort for Joel Embiid, providing a lot of energy for Philadelphia. He notched 8 points in the quarter and has that terrific basketball instinct on display. We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute. Pascal Siakam before the game tonight shared his thoughts reminiscing about his championship year with Kawhi Leonard.
He was always a team, and I think we don't look at one player and say he's going to save us. You know, we got to save each other. We got to play for each other.
And Greg, that's how Siakam plays the game himself.
Versatile, very unselfish, and a franchise player in the making.
And it's been a pretty even game here after one quarter of play. What stands out to you guys from the 76ers in this one?
You got to credit their defense, communicating, rotating, making plays on the ball.
Yeah, I think they wanted to come out of the gate strong, and they have. They've taken the early lead here.
The wingmen will be Van Vliet and Powell.
Take a break.
Siakam is out there with OG Anunoby, and it's Lowry in at the point. So that's the 5 in the game for Toronto. Throw good, Siakam. flattening the lottery odds, Greg. Do you think that's worked out as intended?
You don't hear as many predictions about who's going to get the one pick or the second pick. I think that's good for the players and the fans. You don't want anyone rooting for you to lose.
No, absolutely not. Both good from the line that time.
I mean, the improvement that we've seen from Siakam, it's like nothing else I've ever seen. He's a huge reason for the success of this Raptors team.
Greg, in two short years, this guy triples his output from the floor. He goes from a guy who was getting spot minutes, couldn't really get into the rotation, to an all-star. The transition game, his ability to use that speed, and then his approach, the work habits, both of those two things have been critical to his growth.
Well, I think it's fair to say that Seth Curry has found his footing in this league. He gains more and more confidence every year.
The first one falls. And he makes both free throws.
This is about the last guy you want to send to the stripe right now. They keep fouling him, and he keeps making them.
Siakam looking around. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. That one on Embiid.
Well, great job to put it on the deck and draw the contact. You can see the versatility of Pascal Siakam's game.
The Raptors have shot a good percentage from the free throw line so far. They've made 5 out of 6.
Shooting two.
First free throw is good.
And guys, this is the way to stay in the game. They're doing a masterful job from the line. Perfect this quarter.
No good on the second free throw.
And I'll tell you guys, the leap that Pascal Siakam has taken has really been fun to watch. From role player to emerging star. And guys, he's not done growing yet.
Embiid finds Harris. That shot missing. Now Toronto takes it the other way. Outside Lowry. That doesn't go on the chance to tie. The 76ers leading. And here is Curry. He's making his presence felt offensively with his scoring average up there at almost 13 points a game. And he makes that one.
Well, coaches might discourage that kind of look, but he'll take it anyway.
Van Vliet looking around. The shot by Lowry, no good. The 76ers leading by 4. And Curry has it in the corner. Back to Simmons. Out to the wing. Embiid kicks to Green. Here's Simmons. Rebound by the Raptors. And here in the second, 2 minutes gone by. Van Vliet attacking. Sweet little floater. Van Vliet's got his first bucket in this one.
Well, if you think about Fred VanVleet's handle and his ability to operate at different speeds, you understand how effective he can be on the drive.
Embiid, no good. And so Lowry will bring it up for the Toronto Raptors, trailing by 2. And we're now a little over 2.5 minutes into the second quarter. And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Lowry. The Raptors making a switch here. Baines is checked in. Here's Curry. Passes to Embiid. Kicks it to Green. Harris looking it over. Unloads from 13. And that one hits back iron. Toronto, they've gone 1 of 3 to start out the second quarter. Now Powell, still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him.
Okay, we see the mid-range game of Norman Powell starting to take shape, doing work.
Outside, Green. Feeds to Embiid. Shoots over Baines. And Embiid, the bucket on the assist from Green. Embiid's got 4 points this quarter. And the Raptors call time here.
And you talk about the perfect veteran wing player. Danny Green's right at the top of that list. Solid defense, good shooter, and plays within himself. A moment here to see the numbers for Ben Simmons. 5th in steals, 8th in assists, and not many players convert opportunities inside as well as he. Top 15 in field goal percentage.
And back to what you said, top 5 in steals this year. Quick hands and great anticipation. Lowry passes to Powell. Right wing. Simmons against Lowry. Rebound by Joel Embiid. Embiid's got his 4th rebound in this one. He kicks to Green. 76ers moving the ball around. Shoots a fader. Got it. Number 7 on the night. 7 for 11 from the floor.
All right, defensively now, you've got to find a way to slow this guy down because he's putting it to you.
Van Vliet passes to Siakam. Van Vliet against Curry. The 76ers leading by 4. There's the pass to Simmons. Goes back up, and it's good on the layup.
Intent on keeping that possession alive, Simmons uses his height to his advantage.
Lowry passes to Van Vliet. Powell with it. That's in. He's got 2 made now, and he's shooting 2 for 3.
Put it on the deck, get by the defender, Norman Powell, on the dribble drive. Okay, I see you.
A new group in now for the Raptors. Johnson, he's checked in for Siakam. Thomas comes in for Norman Powell. Davis has checked in for Fred VanVleet. And DeAndre Bembry's subbed in for Kyle Lowry. And the 76ers will go for a different look here. Howard's checked in for Tobias Harris. Korkmaz comes in for Green. Shake Milton, he's checked in for Seth Curry. And Maxey's subbed in for Ben Simmons. Here's Korkmaz. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. fades and shoots. It's not going to go for him. Now Toronto takes it the other way. Johnson kicks to Davis. He takes it in. That one drops for him.
Boy, that's beautiful touch on the floater. And let's remember, not everyone has that shot in their arsenal.
Pass to Howard. Here's Milton. That doesn't fall. Can't drop his first shot. And so it's Johnson who brings the ball up for the Raptors. Trailing by two, Baines dishes to Thomas. Here's the three. It's hauled in by the 76ers.
And the great shooters know when they've got enough opening to go for the three. I didn't think it was a bad choice on that possession.
Now here's Howard. 8 points his last outing. Here's Embiid. Shoots over Baines. Another miss by Philadelphia. The Raptors have gotten a little under 50% of their second quarter shots to find the mark. 4 of 9 all told. Here's Bembry. And they call the foul, so he's got the and-one chance here to make it a three-point play.
Yeah, and there it is again. On a lot of their possessions this first half, they've established great inside position.
The Raptors have scored 6 points from their 8 attempts at the line so far.
And they've had really good numbers all season from the free throw line.
Chris Boucher's checked in for Toronto. And Philadelphia also making a switch. Feibel's checked in. On the free throw, no good. 2-for-1 chance here.
Let's see if they use the clock to their advantage.
Pass to Korkmaz. Let's it go with a three. No good that time. And it's the Raptors taking it the other way. Outside, Davis. To the middle. Got a piece of it. Only one man back on D. Here's Feibel. Nails the corner three. And the 76ers lead by three. Davis with it. 11 points last game. Knocks down the three ball.
And guys getting into a nice groove here, starting to feel it.
And this is partly what the game has become, right? A matter of dueling three-point opportunities.
And that'll do it for the first half. Game time. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Kevin, thanks. Joel, as you look at the game so far, how would you evaluate yourself?
I think defensively I'm doing pretty good. Offensively, I still got to work on a lot of stuff. But it's going well. I just got to calm down, slow down. Let the game come to me and we'll be all good.
Hey, thanks for your time, man. See you in the second half. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks for the great interview, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of basketball following halftime.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, welcome back to 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson alongside Shaquille O'Neal and the Jet, Kenny Smith. Let's get to it. The first quarter for the Raptors was fairly even. They kept at it on both ends of the floor, and at the end of the period, they had a slight deficit of 3 points. Just in terms of the second quarter, they were the better team, but there wasn't a big difference between them. And let's get your thoughts, big fella, on the Raptors.
Well, if you can't shoot the ball, you might want to stop chucking it up. They keep trying the three, but it's not going down. They're relying too much on the three ball, way too much. It's good when it's falling for you, but when it's not, you have to try something else.
And Kenny, what are your thoughts on Philadelphia?
The hostile environment in this building has not been an issue. They've come in here, they focus like they would be at home. And it says something about the character of a team. You need to block out the crowd and just play your game.
And it's just about time now for the third quarter to get underway.
And we're halfway through this one. Plenty of basketball left in a game that's been fairly even so far. Joel Embiid has been sensational.
In those first two quarters, he was pretty much an automatic bucket getter if he got it down low on the block.
Well, you can see why they would continue to play through him. He was tough to stop, super assertive down low, just great work.
And as we get into this third quarter, as we've seen so far, neither team able to create much separation on the scoreboard yet. Taking a look at the 76ers, Harris and Embiid hold down the post for him. Seth Curry is out there with Ben Simmons, and it's Green in at the small forward. Greg, one of your former teammates, John Starks, would get under a guy's skin on the court. He's like a nuisance, but really opposite off the floor, away from the game.
I tell you, Kev, John's got a heart of gold, and anybody that knows him is going to be a fan of the person. John is as good a friend as I can ever recall having.
Four on the clock. But they recover it. Here's Embiid. Toronto grabs the miss. Ananobi's got six rebounds in the game. Outside Lowry. Driving the lane. Over Simmons, and it's blocked by Simmons.
How about the balance and body control? Simmons able to send that one packing. And how about that? What a sensational finish.
Hey, you got to be able to get some hang time to do that one. Van Vliet kicks to Powell. Back to Van Vliet. Outside Lowry. Raptors moving the ball around. Here's Siakam. And it's Philadelphia with the rebound. Embiid's got his sixth rebound on the night. Over a minute and a half into the third quarter of action. And they double up Embiid. Here's Curry with the three. Philadelphia with a new shot clock. Embiid, no good.
Great rim protection to prevent him from converting. Beautiful.
And so Van Vliet will bring it up for the Toronto Raptors. They've only allowed 2 points so far here in the second half. Now here is Lowry. As you can see from his numbers, he's been a key component in their offense. He's averaging almost 18 points a game.
Well, they have the advantage, but you still feel like this guy needs to find a way to get himself going.
Embiid sets the pick for Simmons. The dunk and the foul, a powerhouse move, and he's got a chance for one more at the line. Kyle Lowry picks one up there.
Yeah, how about the concentration by the 6'10" Simmons? Ridiculously good at completing these chances despite the D's best effort.
The 76ers have been successful on three of their four free throw attempts up to this point.
And what a factor Ben Simmons is on the floor. Does so much for this team in every facet of the game. He's a triple-double threat whenever he suits up.
Now, here's Siakam. He's got five, and it's out of bounds. The Raptors able to retain possession here. Aaron Baines, he's checked in for Kyle Lowry. Not quite 2.5 minutes played here in the second half. Here's Powell. And again, no good by Toronto. And sometimes people forget just how young Ben Simmons is, Greg. This is just the beginning for him.
I mean, and that's what fans are missing about Simmons. His age. I mean, you can worry about his shot, but he has a long time to figure it out. He could end up having a Jason Kidd type of a career where he becomes a solid shooter later on.
And here is Siakam. After Tobias Harris getting his shot to go from deep, they need this. Siakam passes to Baines. Here's Powell. And a miss there on the triple. Now here's Simmons. Pass to Harris. Knocked loose. Powell with the steal. We've gone about 3.5 minutes into the third now. Siakam with it. Now guarded by Simmons. Harris dishes to Simmons. And there's the pass to Embiid. Elbow shot. The basket good off the assist from Simmons. Simmons got his fourth assist in this one.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Timeout. Toronto timeout. Calls timeout. Joel Embiid with a strong contribution in this one.
He's just really a one-man wrecking crew down low. And with this timeout, they've got to make some adjustments because he's been steady inside.
Bembry's checked in for Toronto. Then for the 76ers, Dwight Howard. He's checked in for Tobias Harris. Shake Milton comes in for Seth Curry. And Maxey subbed in for Danny Green. Siakam outside. Driving to the basket. And it's sent back by Howard.
Now Dwight Howard at his best, sending it back.
Oh, a tough quarter for him offensively. He hasn't been able to give his team a lift when they need it.
Pass to Maxey. Six on the shot clock. Embiid inside. Baines is there. And the shot goes in from Embiid.
A slight advantage for them in the rebound department, but that oftentimes is all it takes.
Out left to the wing. They need this one. Siakam misses.
No matter what looks they get, they just can't convert to stop this run.
And I think you can start to feel their frustration mounting. With every missed bucket, it becomes more and more desperate.
Now here's Simmons. Following the miss by Pascal Siakam. And Simmons slams it in.
What breathtaking quickness by Simmons. So good at blowing by whoever is brave enough to try to take him on.
And the Raptors with some changes. Chris Boucher's checked in for Aaron Baines, and it's Johnson in for Powell. And then for Philadelphia, Korkmaz checked in for Joel Embiid, and Matisse Thybulle subbed in for Ben Simmons. Raptors trail by 11. Here's Bembry. Pass to Van Vliet. Launches it. Maxey grabs the miss.
And you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Passes it to Howard. Here's Maxey. Driving inside. Siakam pulls it in. Van Vliet outside. Off the mark, and the drop continues.
The shooting numbers just aren't there yet in the quarter.
It's Korkmaz in the corner. Over Johnson. And misses it off the right side of the rim.
I didn't see that miss coming. I mean, he's usually been money from that range.
Looking to end his cold spell, and the call on the shot that sends him to the line. That's on Dwight Howard.
Now Pascal Siakam looking aggressive and determined, which forces the defender to commit the foul.
He's made three of his four free throw attempts in the game.
An 80% shooter. The work he's done at the line this season, one word, solid.
He's off on the first, and the Raptors with some changes. Thomas comes in for Fred VanVleet, and it's Lowry in for Bembry. And he sinks the second. Well, Greg, Pascal Siakam won Most Improved Player in the league in 2019. And as we've talked about, had a case for it again in the 2020 voting.
I tell you, Siakam's play jumped so much again. He deserved the recognition. He continued to press himself to be an elite forward rare for a former MIP winner to even be considered for the award more than once.
And Toronto making a change here. Davis has checked in. Defense doesn't get much better than the mobile one block we just saw on replay.
Determined to protect the lead with the all-out effort defensively. Superb anticipation on the block.
29 seconds left to play here in the third. Floats one, and he lays it up and in. Davis has got 7 points in the game.
Well, the touch and the focus. What a pretty move in the lane.
Here's Korkmaz. No points in the game yet for him. For the three. And we've reached the end of the third. 76ers ahead as they end the third quarter on a 14-3 run. We'll be back shortly, live from Toronto. And let's take this chance now to show you the State Farm assist of the game.
Yeah, and I like the fact we get to see this pass one more time. A magnificent feed. And you love to see your off guard taking over the playmaking duties with this much skill.
You love the unselfishness, finding the best look, and it doesn't matter who's taking it.
And with three quarters behind us, let's see what this fourth period holds in store for us. All right, now a chance to set the floor courtesy of Gatorade. Fourth quarter action, all fueled up and ready to go. Setting the floor for the Raptors. Davis is out there with Lowry. Then there's Norman Powell. Then it's Pascal Siakam. And it's Anunoby in at the four-man position. And the foul called on OG Anunoby. That is his first foul of the game. On the wing, Green. The basket good off the assist from Simmons. Simmons got 5 assists in the game.
Danny Green is one of the best catch-and-shoot players in the league. Makes it look easy.
Now, here's Siakam. And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Embiid. And the Raptors making a change here. Van Vliet's checked in. Now the pass to Anunoby. Now Lowry. Raptors moving the ball around. Out of bounds. Philadelphia takes possession. The 76ers leading by 11. And here is Simmons. Embiid, the pass to Curry. Another three for Philadelphia.
Yeah, those are starting to add up, guys. Of their last 5 baskets, 3 have been triples.
Here's Lowry driving in, banked in off the glass.
Boy, it looked like he put himself in a tough spot, and Lowry thought he'd get a whistle with the drive and the contact. No help from the officials, but he didn't need it, Kevin.
Now here's Simmons. Pass to Embiid. Fourth quarter now, we're about a minute and a half in, and the shot goes in.
The edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead.
Curry against Van Vliet, outside Lowry, fires the three, and it's Philadelphia with the rebound.
I'll tell you, you hate to pin this on one person, but his inefficiencies at the offensive end are holding this group back.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score, or just great ball movement.
And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for the 76ers.
They keep piling up the assists, and they haven't cooled off at all.
The number of second-chance points they've gotten has also been big. They've kept so many possessions alive with offensive rebounds.
The 2018 Rookie of the Year, Simmons' NBA career got off to a great start, and he's only continued to improve.
Now here's Van Vliet. Embiid with the steal. And Ben Simmons picks up the foul. That's his first foul.
Yeah, but just the second turnover of the game. I mean, overall, pretty meticulous offensively.
Raptors trail by 17. Now Van Vliet. Looking to get it going. And the layup is good.
Well, you get exactly what you want right there. Clean look right at the cup. Nicely done.
And here's Simmons. He'll bring it up for the Philadelphia 76ers. Curry on the wing. From 11 feet away, it doesn't go for him. And it's the Raptors taking it the other way.
I'll tell you, despite his struggles at the offensive end, this team still finds themselves in control of the ballgame.
Lowry passes to Baines. No good on the three.
And with the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in the driver's seat.
Harris with it. Here's Embiid. It's rebounded by Anunoby. Anunoby's got his seventh rebound here tonight. Now here's Van Vliet. Outside Lowry. The 76ers leading by 15. Curry on the wing. To the paint. And Embiid, the bucket on the assist by Curry. Embiid's got 4 points in the quarter.
When you think of Seth Curry, you're thinking shooting. But there, what a pretty pass to find the open man.
Here's Powell. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two.
Well, Norman Powell these last several seasons has turned himself into a knockdown shooter. And obviously last season much more involved on the offensive end. And that, to me, was his best performance to date.
That one is off.
And with Powell, they rely on his shooting to open things up for everyone else.
Yeah, and for Norman Powell, he knows what he's about and welcomes that role. This is a guy who understands how to relocate in the midst of plays to create separation from defenders. He's always ready in catch-and-shoot situations.
And the second free throw, good.
Well, one thing there's no question about is that Norman Powell is a gifted athlete. Now it's about rounding out that game, particularly his shooting.
Now here's Green. Embiid inside, covered by Siakam. Shot from six. And he can't bank that one in. Raptors trail by 16. And here is Van Vliet.
And I'll tell you, they're going to need more from this guy if they're going to cut into this deficit.
Now Simmons, outside Green. Pass to Embiid. Baseline Jay on the way. Good, and it's Green picking up the assist. Embiid's got 6 points in the quarter.
And guys, we've become accustomed to this. Embiid's a dynamic scorer who's comfortable shouldering the offensive load.
Siakam, that's good.
And that solid play in the paint continues here, guys.
The 76ers leading by 16. Passes it to Harris. Outside Curry. And it's denied. Sent back by Siakam. And Philadelphia making a change here. Milton's checked in. .144 left here in the fourth quarter. Shot clock at 2. Simmons can't get it to go.
And he's a good shooter from outside, but not sure from that deep.
Boy, we're seeing it more and more. Guys looking to create additional space by stepping back further from the line.
Philadelphia's gone 2-3 in the fourth quarter from long range. Good shooting so far.
And so just rolling to the finish line now in what has been a very confident-looking performance for the 76ers.
And they had to battle for this win. There were times when it looked like it was maybe slipping away a bit, but they never let that happen, which I thought was a real credit to them.
And that's a product of their mental toughness. Anytime the flow of the game turned against them, instead of caving, they just dialed it up a notch and were able to pull away.
And I think a great job in positioning themselves for the W here. It's win number 21 on the season.
And as we get set to put this one to bed, a one-sided season series thus far, they've won two straight.
The one player that really stands out, of course, in this one, it was a dazzling game for Joel Embiid.
Boy, I thought his best work was his pursuit of the basketball. He competed for every rebound, fought for position in the paint, and never stopped working. I love it.
And now, let's present our New Balance Player of the Game, Joel Embiid.
And he's been out there doing his thing, just dominating on the glass. There aren't many players who put more into their rebounding than he does. And we saw that again tonight. Nobody could match his effort on the boards.
And as the star of this team, he knows he's going to be the object of the crowd's anger. Here's Boucher, Johnson outside. Good ball movement here by the Raptors. Now here's Flynn. Defense is right there. And the Raptors miss again.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
Howard.
Shoots from 12. And it's off the back rim. No good. And so it's Johnson who brings the ball up for Toronto. It's an 18-point game. Outside Flynn. And it's the 76ers with the ball. 18 points separating the teams. That's the biggest lead of the game. Maxey passes to Scott. Here's Maxey, covered by Flynn. Down to 5 on the shot clock. There's the pass to Howard. Over Thomas. And the foul called on Korkmaz.
Loose ball.
Is his first foul of the game.
Go the other way.
Let's go. Flynn with it. So it's Philadelphia winning this one easily. This crowd was stunned by the manner in which their team was dismantled.
You know what? Shocking. I don't care what the matchup is. You never expect a road team to come in and just cruise to the kind of win they did tonight.
And we've got David Aldridge standing by on our sideline with the player of the game. David, it's all yours.
Hey, Kevin, thank you. Joel, you took over offensively. What went into finding that rhythm?
I thought I got the shots that I wanted, and I played into the flow of the offense, and my teammates were finding me, so I just knocked down some shots.
Well, they were smart to look for you, man, because you had it going on, man. Congrats. Back to you, Kevin.
David, thank you as always. And that about wraps it up for Doris Burke, David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, and the rest of our terrific 2K Sports crew. This is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. So long, everyone.